Hey, this is Chris Menard. We're going to take a look at creating a custom sort list. I'm going to do this twice, one for months, but I'm going to do one for some car brands, but I'm going to do a cool trick using Excel's data tab. I'm going to remove some duplicates to quickly create my custom sort list. The steps for this I'm doing on the Windows machine. I will put the steps for the Mac down in the description down below because they are different, but you can do this on the Mac just to be really clear about it. Example number one, I'm on the worksheet and I've got a list of car brands listed in column B. I want to sort by the car brand and I do want to sort alphabetically A to Z, but I want Ford to always be at the very top of that sorted list, followed by Toyota, then the other car brands A to Z. So I'm going to use Excel's remove duplicate features to create this custom sort list. I'm going to select column B and copy it. Add a new worksheet. This is temporary where you don't need to save this. Go ahead and do a paste. Leave it selected. So the word brand and all the car brands are selected. Let's move to the data tab at the top. And over in data tools, we have remove duplicates. It picked up the header row brand, click OK, click OK again. So here are the car brands. I'm going to go ahead and right click on one of them and do a sort A to Z. They are sorted A to Z, but I want Ford all the way at the top. You could, I'm going to do this two different ways. You could cut Ford, right click on cell A2 and insert cut cells. Notice Ford and then Acura move down. So you didn't replace anything or lose anything. I'm going to do an undo, control Z. The other method for this is I've got my mouse on the top border of Ford. I'm holding down the shift key. Don't let go of shift. I'm going to drag Ford. Going to let go of the mouse, let go of the shift key. Now Ford is up there. It is the same I did as the first example with the cut cells. I'm just using the shift key and the mouse. And then I believe we said Toyota will be next. Again, just put that as the second one. So this is the order that I want to sort in. I need to select it. We're going to go to File and Options. Click on the word Advanced over on the left. Scroll all the way to the bottom. Just grab the scroll bar and go all the way to the very bottom. And I'm looking for Edit Custom Lists. When you click on Edit Custom List, notice that Sunday, Monday, Tuesday are in there twice. Three letters and then fully spelled out. Microsoft Excel put those in here. And then the same thing with the month. So those four are already in here. I'm going to import what I have highlighted. There they are. So now they're part of my custom sort list. Click OK. Click OK. If you're using a Mac, the steps are slightly different. I do have those listed down below in the help files. Now, this worksheet, there is no need to save it, but if you wanted to, you could. I'm actually just going to right-click and delete it, but if you want to save it, you can. Back to this worksheet called, the first worksheet called 1 year. Let's use our custom sort. Data tab, sort. What do you want to sort by? I want to sort by the brand. I do not want to sort A to Z. I'm going to use my custom list. Ford, Toyota, Acura, click OK, click OK. I'm just going to scroll through and just make sure that it worked. I see Ford, I see Toyota, and then there's Acura followed by BMW. Perfect. One more example. This one's also very popular. I'm on the next worksheet called Months. Column G has got a list of months in here, so I could do a sort A to Z. Let's do that one real quick. Right click on cell G2, sort A to Z. It did sort A to Z, April, August, December. Well, that's not what I want. Data sort, sort by month, custom lists, the fourth one down, because I got the month spelled out in this example, but if they were three letters, you'd use the one that's three letters. Click OK, click OK. there is January through December. But a lot of companies work off a fiscal year. So it's not always January through December. It could be July through June, could be October through September. So this one's a pretty easy one to set up. I'm over in cell K2. I'm going to make this start off in July. Autofill, pull down until I get to June, leave it highlighted. Same steps as when we did the brands. File, options, advance all the way to the bottom. Edit custom list. We're going to do an import. Click OK. Click OK. Delete what you have over here. Again, you don't need it. Let's go see if it works. Sort. Custom lists. There you go. July through June. I hope you enjoyed this video. I appreciate your time. Thank you.